5-minute bios, short on time, long on info, with George Fritchie. Today, Cornelius Vanderbilt. Cornelius Vanderbilt, 1794 to 1877, was an American industrialist who played a crucial role in the development of the American economy during the 19th century. His influence extended across several industries, particularly in railroading and shipping. Vanderbilt was often referred to as the Commodore, a nickname he received due to his involvement in the shipping industry. Cornelius Vanderbilt was born on May 27, 1794, in Staten Island, New York. He took his first steps into the business world as a ferry operator, and he soon developed a reputation for offering extremely competitive rates. Vanderbilt expanded his shipping operations and began operating steamboats, having recognized the economic advantages of steam propulsion. He employed aggressive competitive strategies to gain market share and drive competitors out of the market. This approach brought him great success and led him to become one of the richest men of his time. As time went on, Vanderbilt recognized the potential of the growing railroad industry in the United States. He subsequently invested in railroad companies. His ability to consolidate and control various companies gave him tremendous power in the railroad industry. This allowed him to control rates and influence competition. Cornelius Vanderbilt contributed significantly to the development of the American economy, particularly in the area of mobility. His efforts helped improve national commerce, increase the mobility of people and goods, and expand markets. His concepts of efficiency, competition, and entrepreneurship shaped the emergence of modern capitalism in the United States. He was married twice. His first wife was Sophia Johnson, whom he married in 1813. After her death, he married Frank Armstrong Crawford in 1869, who had become a widow in 1868. Cornelius Vanderbilt had 13 children, all from his first marriage to Sophia Johnson. Vanderbilt was one of the wealthiest men of his era during his lifetime. His estimated fortune reached over $100 million at its peak, which would be equivalent to over $150 billion in today's purchasing power. Vanderbilt's contribution to infrastructure and the integration of Western territories into national markets cannot be overestimated. The construction of rail lines brought the West into the nation's commerce and economic development. Grand Central Station in Manhattan was built by him. He donated $1 million to the founding of Vanderbilt University in Nashville, Tennessee. Although Vanderbilt was considered an unscrupulous businessman, his work contributed significantly to a thriving economy in the United States. His success and methods influenced generations of entrepreneurs. He was the epitome of the robber baron, exploiting raw materials or other resources unmolested by politics to build an empire at the expense of his competitors and employees. Vanderbilt died on January 4, 1877, at the age of 82. He was buried in a family vault in Moravian Cemetery in Staten Island, New York. Well, so much for Cornelius Vanderbilt. And until the next episode of 5-Minute Bios.